have something in this legislation called the CLASS Act. It'll allow for the first time in the history of this country disabled people, people who are working, to plan ahead in case they do become disabled, fully paid for. CBO said in the far future, decades and decades in the future, paid for. I didn't use a penny of that money for the bill that's before the Senate.
The CLASS Act, which allows individual people at no government expense to contribute to their own long-term care needs, is one of the most innovative and creative ideas in our bill.
And so, again, bottom line, even apart from the CLASS Act, the bill's running a surplus, and then there are a variety of tweaks that are being explored to make sure that the CLASS Act is on a firm financial footing on its own 2 feet.
And Mr. President, the CBO has scored this. This is completely paid for over 75 years. Over 75 years. I don't understand why anyone wanted to strike it.
The fact that this program is virtually solvent for 30 straight years is an indication of the wisdom of that idea and the way it is planned.
Some have suggested that the CLASS Act is fiscally not sound. The Gregg Amendment should put those concerns to rest.
So you get a lot of bangs for the buck, as you might say, with the CLASS Act that we have in this bill.
And an amendment to ensure that the voluntary long-term insurance program, the CLASS Act, remains solvent over 75 years. We have taken those amendments. They are now law. Now my Republican friends are saying they want to repeal the bill. This is going out all across the airways. They want to repeal the bill.